A check on local trade now. The PSEI opens the week in the green. It closed at 66.04 after jumping over 1%. Daily turnover, or value turnover, was nearly 11 billion pesos. Miko Sayo of Chupitero.com now joins us for his take on today's trading. Hi, Miko.
Hi, Stanley. Good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Let's talk about the main event at the PSE today, the debut of Oceana Gold Philippines. What kind of price action did you see today for this debut?
Well, the stock was immediately down in the first couple of minutes of trading, and it stayed down for the rest of the day. And it closed the day, I think, down by about more than 6%. So it wasn't really a very good day for the bulls of Oceana today.
Okay, now Miko, one of the most common feedback we've had about the stock, OGP, is its price, which many find to be a few pesos below its debut offer of 13.33. At least that's the real value for them. Now, to what level do you think would the market correct for OGPI to achieve what it feels is the stock's acceptable price?
Well, from the way I see it, just to be at par with the valuations of the most comparable stocks in the market, which is Philex and Apex, the stock would have to drop to at least 11 pesos per share. Okay. So that's just so they would be at par with the valuations of those two companies.
Okay, now Migo, this is notably the first IPO in the mining sector in the Philippines in 12 years. The last one, I think, was 2012. Now, do you think its addition to the mining names that we currently have will be significant in terms of improving the quality of mining stocks in our basket?
Well, there's actually just two gold and copper plays in the market that the market has been trading in the last couple of days, in spite of the strong performance of gold in the world market, and that's Philex and Apex. No, so at least we have another company that traders can trade and invest in.
Yes, Miko, we know we're coming from 17 peso a piece initial plan for OGP. It debuted at 13.30, and they're saying that it still going to go down. Investors think the real value would be a few pesos below 13.33, its debut price. Aren't investors considering the fact that this is also a high dividend playing stock?
Well, based on the behavior of the prices today, I guess they're looking more at the premium valuation rather than the yield, Of course, at some point, when prices go a bit lower, maybe closer to 10, then maybe investors will probably think more about the yield then.
All right, Miko, our other stories today, we have Belcorp applying for voluntary delisting of its unit Prime Leisure Corporation, or PLC, by July through a tender offer of 85 centavos apiece. What do you think of that price?
Well, just imagine, in 2014, Bell sold more than 3 billion shares at 165, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah.
And now they're buying back the shares 10 years after, they're buying back the shares at 85 cents. So, do you think there's something wrong with that?
All right. Now, are you seeing more companies delisting from the PSEI moving forward? Because aside from liquidity issues of this market, why do you think it's making sense for more companies to go private now?
Well, allow me to be the devil's advocate. Here's what a shrewd or a cunning businessman will do, though. He asked this company. He would sell his shares in the market at a very high price, hype up the stock, hype up the company. And a few years later, when maybe the company isn't doing very well anymore and isn't as hyped as when he did an IPO, he would announce that he decides to delist the company and go private again and buy back all the shares at a lower price.
No, so right. Yeah.
So it's a very profitable scheme for a very shrewd businessman, if you ask me.
Yes, Amiko, in your years of trading, has this been, one of those years that we see more delistings, or is there a similar wave in the past that this happened as well?
Well, as far as I can remember, parang this has been more common or more rampant in the last couple of months, couple of years. I don't think I've experienced this type of scenarios and delistings the last few years that I've been trading.
All right, now for data this week, we're looking forward to the BSP's policy decision set for Thursday. Well, widely expected as a pause. Are you expecting any change in tone? I mean, are investors expecting a shift to dovishness for the BSP?
No, I don't think so. The slower than expected growth in the GDP was dovish, no? But it was followed by a slight increase in the Q1 inflation, which is hawkish. So it's like, it evened out each other, no? So I don't expect any changes from the BSP at this point.
Same old then. Lastly, for market track, what are your trends? What are the trends for current prices in terms of support and resistance levels included? And the price action you're expecting to see now that most important data, I mean, at least earnings, have wind down.
The PSE is currently stuck within the 6,400 to 6,800 range with some minor support and resistances at 6,500 and 6,700. I don't really see any big catalysts in the short term, so I expect the market to just continue to be range bound in the short term. Maybe one important market moving data or event would be on Thursday when the MSCI announces its changes.
Yes, and
So
are you expecting changes there, by the way? Or just the weights?
not at the moment.
Okay.
I haven't really seen the data yet to give you a good forecast for that. But in terms of the index, for example, no, we have some issues that could have some downweights and upweights soon when the PSE announces their data sometime in August.
All right, Nico Sayo, founder of Chipitero.com. Again, a pleasure talking to you today.
Thank you, Stanley.